Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about the differences between the format that you're going to get with your C++ 20 compiler and the lib format that standard format is based on. So as always, before moving on, I want to point out that you should check out the notes in the video description below and be aware that you can suggest and vote on episode ideas and be sure to check out my books and consider hiring me to do training on site at your company. So first and foremost, I want to point out that I have GCC trunk mode with C++ 20 enabled, and I have included the format header from libformat, standalone library. Why have I started here? Well, if I want to include format from my standard library, I can't yet. At the moment, only Visual Studio's standard library actually has the format library available to it. So let's just go ahead and start here by taking care of some notes. So lib format, this is available today for every compiler. And the standard library format header, this is only available on Visual Studio. The next thing that I want to talk about is how to actually print something to the screen with format. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to Visual Studio so that we can a little bit swap back and forth on these things. So let's go ahead and include the format header. Now I just want to do a very simple output. And you've probably already seen this before in a previous episode of C++ Weekly, but we don't actually have any way with standard format to send output to the console. So that's a little disappointing. And you end up having to do something kind of like this, which ends up being very disappointing, really. So there is a slightly better way to do this. And it's kind of like this, but you end up just feeling bad after you've done this. It's perfectly valid and legal. We're getting a character string pointer to the standard string that was produced by the call to standard format, sending that to standard put string puts, and we get hello 42 printed. Now, keeping in mind I have full optimizations enabled, Visual Studio, shall we say, seems to be generating a fair bit more code than it needs to. I'm not entirely sure why or what's going on here. It looks like considerable amount of data tables. So we're just not going to focus on that too much. But this code should make you sad. With libformat, on the other hand, well, at the moment, I'm getting a linker error for this, but we're not going to blame any of the libraries or our compiler or anything like this. This is probably just a configuration issue with Visual Studio on Compiler Explorer and trying to execute the binary with the library. But we have format print, and as we can see, this does compile. It just doesn't execute at the moment in the context in which we are testing this. We have this handy print function from libformat, but our standard format header doesn't get this until C++ 23. Okay, so the next thing can be looked at as both good and bad, depending on your perspective. Our format header moves with the C++ standard, and it is ABI stable. Depending on what you're looking for, this could be very important to you. On the other hand, the standalone libformat is constantly being improved with bug fixes, performance fixes, there are updates available. As far as I know, it does not have guaranteed ABI stability, but I could be wrong about that. I'm pretty sure that it does not have guaranteed ABI stability. So that might be a concern for you, again, depending on your perspective. Now, a kind of a nebulous concept, but coming back to the print function, is that libformat has a lot more utility built in. It's simply a bigger library. And so there's more helpers and more things that you might want from it. Now, the eighth and final thing that I want to mention about libformat might surprise you a little bit. So I'm going to switch compilers again, and we'll give this a test. And so here we go. We can actually do a constexpr compile time formatting of a string. And that is not something that is possible with the standard library version of format. Now, I did actually use this particular feature in my talk from CBPCon of 2021 called Your New Mental Model for Constexpr. But we can see that this is clearly just calling puts with these bytes that are right here. It's not a very long string or anything, and it works quite well. And we can also see that if we made a string that is too long to actually fit in this format too, then we're going to get a compile time error. So you don't have to worry about, you know, buffer overruns or anything like that in this particular example. Now, there is a quick change here that I would like to make just to prove a point. So this is still the same, except we see that we have 9,992 zeros following the end of the string. So you can see here that if I took off that static, then I actually do a copy of the data into the local stack. And this is exactly what the point of that episode, stop using constexpr and use this instead, was all about, was that we, if we have a constexpr local value, we probably want it to be static. But then I also want to point out that if I remove constexpr from this entirely, that I do still actually see the formatting of the string happening here. So even though the function is constexpr, the compiler is not choosing to do this at compile time. If I want this, I pretty much want to do the constexpr static auto thing here. And now there is the conversations that we've had in the past on this channel about forcing work at compile time, and you can go back and look at those to make sure you get a deeper understanding of these things. But yeah, the conclusion ultimately. So if you're in an environment where you have to use only the standard library provided things, and you have a compiler that's new enough that you actually have the standard format header and can use it, then go ahead and use that. Otherwise, if you're in an environment where you do have some sort of package manager or some way to take advantage of libformat, then I think it wins in this comparison here. There's many more things to have dug into, but I thought that it was worth talking about these differences. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. You know what to do, subscribe, thumbs up, all the things.